Good morning everyone, I welcome you to lecture 5 of multiphase flows. So today we'll continue a bit more on scaling analysis. Last class we had seen a basic introduction to how to use scaling analysis to analyze the physics of the problem under different limits. So today I'll be looking at a transient problem, a problem which evolves in time. So the last class we had a problem wherein the flow was kind of steady, so there was no time scale involved. Today we are looking at a problem which is unsteady and it evolves in time. So the problem that we are going to look at today is a fluid which is confined between two walls. The top wall is stationary and the bottom wall is going to be moving periodically, given by u x in the x direction, u naught times cos omega t. Okay, and the top wall is stationary. So, and my coordinate system is x in this direction and y in the perpendicular direction. Okay, so this is the problem that we are going to look at. So, it's a transient problem. So, at time t equal to 0, the fluid is at rest, and we look at the case wherein the bottom wall is set into motion periodically. And right now there are three scales, time scales in the problem, which we will be seeing shortly. So the thing that we'll be discussing today is essentially three things. The first one is when we can neglect the initial transients. So we'll be finding out conditions under which we can neglect the initial transients. The second thing that we'll be looking at is a case called as pseudo steady state or something called as quasi steady state. So we'll find out conditions under which we can assume that the flow is essentially at an approximation which is called as a pseudo steady state approximation. And the third thing is we'll find out the region of influence where the wall motion is significant. So essentially what I am saying is that in the third condition, I am saying that the flow of the motion of the wall is going to affect the flow only till a particular region of influence, something called as delta. So these are essentially three cases that we are going to discuss. The first is wherein I have the motion of the wall set into motion at some time t equal to 0, and we are going to find out the conditions under which we can neglect the initial transients. In the second case, we look at the case where we can say that the quasi steady state approximation holds true. And the third is the case where we will be looking at where the motion of the wall is only influencing till a particular depth. It's called the region of influence delta, which we'll be finding out through scaling. Okay. So we'll go to step one, as was discussed in the last class, which is nothing but writing down the governing equations in the dimensional form. So as in any fluid flow problem, the continuity equation and the Navier-Stokes equation are the governing equations. So we have the two equations given as these. Okay, so we have the continuity equation, which is nothing but mass conservation, and we have the Navier-Stokes equation, which is nothing but Newton's second law applied for the fluid. Okay, so we'll write it down in the expanded form for the three directions. So we fundamentally assume that the flow is one dimensional, so you only have an x component of velocity. Okay, so we assume that you only have ux, ui and uz are 0, so this is my u vector or the v vector basically in this problem. Okay, so we have v given by this particular vector. Okay, now if I substitute this into the continuity equation, I would get that my vx is not varying with time, varying in space x. So dou vx by dou x is 0, which basically means that my flow is fully developed. Whatever I have at x equal to 1 point is the same as it would be at any other x. Okay, so this is my first equation, the governing equation, the continuity equation. If I substitute vx and you know vy and vz to be 0 in this particular governing equation, the Navier-Stokes equation, you will see that very easily we can find out that the governing equation would be dou vx by dou t given by mu times dou square vx by dou y square. Okay, and this is the x component of the Navier-Stokes equation. The y equation in the absence of gravity would eventually be very easy, and you would get dp by dy equals to 0, which basically means that pressure is not changing in y direction. This is in the absence of gravity, so we are neglecting gravity in this problem. Okay, so this is my equation that I have. Okay, so we can basically neglect this equation, it just tells me that pressure is not changing in y, and this just tells me that my velocity in the x direction is not going to change in the x direction. So the basic equation that we are left with is this one, which I'll call as 1. Okay, so we have finished our step 1, wherein we have got the governing equations in the dimensional form. Okay, now we go to step 2. Step 2 essentially involves choosing reference scales to non-dimensionalize the problem. So we choose Vx scale to be the scale for the x direction velocity component. Then we have a Ts, which is the scale for time, and then we have the y direction. So we choose a scale in the y direction to be given by Ys. Okay, so our non-dimensional velocities is given by Vx by Vxs. Non-dimensional time is given by time by Ts. And the non-dimensional y direction length is given by y star being y by Ys. Okay, so these are the non-dimensional variables that we are going to use. We substitute in step 3. Now we just substitute these variables into the governing equations that we had got. We neglect the first and the last equation, we just directly look at equation 1, because that is the one which is helping me to find out how my Vx is going to change in time. So I write down rho multiplying Vx scale Vx star by dou t star. So I have a time scale coming in here, multiplying by mu times Vx into dou square Vx by dou y star squared. So these are the governing equations that we get once we have non-dimensionalized it. So what we have accompanying these governing equation is the initial and the boundary condition, which basically means my velocity is 0 at time t equal to 0, okay, and my velocity vx is 0 at y equals to h, where h is the distance between the two plates, and my vx is u naught cos omega t at y equals to 0. So these are the initial and boundary conditions which are used to solve this problem that we have. So non-dimensionalizing the boundary conditions and the initial conditions, we get vx into vx scale equals to 0 at t times equals to 0. This is the initial condition we have. Next, we have the boundary condition at y equals to h, which is given by vx star times vxs equals to 0 at y star times ys equals to h, okay. And then the third condition, we have vx star times vxs equals u naught cos omega t star times ts, you know, at y star times ys equals to 0, okay. Now, next we just rearrange the equation and the initial conditions and the boundary conditions. So this was our vx, and this height is given by h, okay. So we just rewrite the equations and we get rho times ys square by mu times ts dou vx star by dou t star equals dou square vx star by dou y star square. So I just rearranged the governing equation, got all the coefficients onto the left hand side to get a term here which multiplies my dou v by dou t. Okay. Now I do the same thing for the initial condition and the boundary condition. So I would get vx star equals to 0 at t star equals to 0. We get vx star equals to 0 at y star by y star equals to h by ys, and we get vx star equals u naught by vx scale cos omega ts at y star equals to 0, okay. So this I get just by rearranging the terms in the initial condition and the boundary condition, okay. So one time scale that is very evident from the problem is the time scale associated with the periodic motion, which is given by omega. So omega basically tells me the frequency at which the plate is moving. So we have a time scale directly given by, you know, omega. And the other problem, the other time scale that involves is the motion of the wall should be diffusing into the fluid and reaching the entire, you know, the domain that the fluid is present in. So we have a time which is called the viscous time scale, which is basically the time scale associated with the motion of the wall being transported because of viscous forces throughout the domain, Okay, so one time scale that we very evidently have is the periodic motion of the ball. The another time scale of the problem is the time scale which is associated with the motion of the ball being transported throughout the domain. Okay, so these time scales we can directly get using the scaling analysis. So we look at the equation which is the governing equation 1. The initial condition is given by 2, we have the boundary conditions given by 3 and 4. Okay, if I look at 3 and 4, we directly can see that, you know, using the order of 1 magnitude analysis, we can choose our ys to be h. Okay, so that y star goes from 0 to 1. Okay, and then from here we see that we directly have a velocity scale which is given by vx s being u naught. So that, you know, Vx star goes from 0 to order of 1. So we can choose one particular scales. So this is case 1 where I am choosing my y scale to be h, my velocity scale to be u naught. Okay, so I am going to say that my velocity is going to vary from, you know, y equal to 0 to h. So there is the motion is being driven by the ball throughout the domain. So that comes by choosing the scale y is equal to h. So and then I have my velocity scale which is given by vx equal to u naught, which tells me that my velocity of the ball is important in this problem. So I have retained both the physics. I am telling that my velocity of the ball is important and that the flow will be affected throughout the domain when I choose ys is h. Okay, now we'll just substitute these into the equation. Before that, we know that we have to choose a scale for time 2. Okay, so we have a choice for time scale from the problem here. We could look at equation 4 and we could make this particular term of order 1 and get a scaling for the time directly, which basically means that I could choose my time scale to be given by 2 pi by omega, which means the frequency of the wall motion is the time scale that I am choosing. So that can be called as something as TSP, wherein is the time scale associated with the periodic motion of the wall. So I have one time scale which is given by 2 pi by omega. Okay, now once I have chosen ys as h, vx as u naught, I could substitute these into the governing equation 1, make this term 1, you know, then I would get a time scale if I just substitute vx here, the ys here. So which means that I could get one more time scale which I would right now call it as TSV. Okay, which can be made by just substituting ys is h and vxs is u naught. Okay, and I am making that term which is the coefficient in equation 1 to be 1. So that means rho ys square by mu times ts can be made 1. Okay, if I do that, I will get a time scale associated with this particular scaling to be h square by mu by rho, or basically h squared by nu. Okay, so what we have essentially done right now when we have said that this particular term rho y squared by mu ts is 1 is that we have said that dvx by dt is important in the problem. And the right hand side was basically the viscous term, you know, you got it from the second derivative of velocity coming in the Navier-Stokes equation. So that was the viscous term and this is the transient term. So right now when we have found out a time scale by equating these two terms, what we are saying is that the time scale is the one which is associated with the effect of the motion of the wall to penetrate throughout the domain H through the viscous forces. So that's why I've called this as TSV, which is nothing but the time scale associated with the viscous transport, you know. So the fluid has transported the motion of the wall throughout the domain, and this time scale is the time scale associated with that transport. So how much time it would take, you know, for that motion of the wall to be transported throughout the domain. So that gives, that is given by this particular TSV. Okay, the another time scale which is present in any transient problem is the time scale associated with the observation time scale, which I'll just call it as T0. Okay, so we have a time scale associated with just the problem being transient. So which means that this could essentially vary from 0 to infinity. So I could start observing the flow from any time t equal to 0 to an infinite time. So this is a problem, this is a time scale which is present in any transient problem. The other two time scales that we have observed, the periodic one and the viscous time scales, were obtained because we have a problem which is periodically being driven. So that is the time scale associated with the periodic motion of the wall. And then the viscous time scale is the time scale which is corresponding to the, you know, motion of the wall being transported throughout the entire domain. So we could scale the problem using any of the three time scales, and we'll see that, you know, we could get different physics out of the same problem using the different time scales. Okay, so I'll just go to equation one again. So I have choosing ys to be h, I have rho h squared by mu by time scale is the time scale which I would take to be the one associated with the periodic motion of the wall. So I would get something like this. Okay, this is multiplying dou v x star by dou t star equals to mu times equals to dou square v x by dou y square. Okay, so what we see here, the term that is multiplying dou vx by dou t star is nothing but, you know, we could rewrite this particular term as h squared by nu, which is mu by rho, by 2 pi by omega. Okay, so this thing h squared by nu was the time scale which was associated with the viscous transport in the problem which we had got here, TSV. So we could rewrite this term again as, you know, TSV by TSP dou V star by dou T star giving dou square V x star by dou y star square. Okay, so if you look at the left hand side of this equation, we have TSV by TSP. Okay, we could neglect this term only under the condition that TSV is much much less than TSP. Okay, if this condition is satisfied, then we could essentially neglect the left hand side. Okay, and then we would get an equation which was dou square vx by dou y star square equals to 0. Okay, now if you see the governing equation, it's a simplified form of the actual governing equation that you had started with. You had a transient term. Right now, under these conditions, we know that there is no dou v by dou t, which essentially means that the problem is independent of time, at least in the governing equation. Okay, so this particular case is the quasi steady state approximation, you know. So you can have a quasi steady state approximation only under the condition that the viscous time scale is very less compared to the periodic motion of the wall. Okay, and then this can be easily solved. Like, you know, the second derivative of vx with y is 0, so you could just integrate this you know, so you'll get Vx okay. And to solve this problem, we have the two boundary conditions, which where Vx star is 0 at y star equals to 1 and Vx star is cos 2 pi t star at y star equals to 0. Okay. So, if you use these boundary conditions, you could easily solve and get the velocity profile directly. Okay. So, we have looked at the problem and found out the condition under which we could use the quasi steady state approximation and get a simplified solution to the flow. Okay. The second case is essentially we'll be finding out the condition under which we could say that the transients of the problem have been died down. Okay. So that essentially corresponds to a time scale T naught being much greater than the time scale associated with the periodic motion. So I had the three time scales in the problem. So the T naught was the observation time scale. So I have gone till what time, you know, I have waited till what time is the one which basically tells you the T naught. It's basically the physical time associated in the problem. So if I have waited long enough compared to the time scale of the oscillation, then I could say that the initial transients have, you know, kind of died down. So this condition or T naught is greater than 2 pi by omega. Okay. So this particular condition is the one which helps you tell under these conditions the initial transients can be neglected. So the case 3 was the case where we are going to find out when the motion of the wall is confined to some region of influence. Okay. So we have the governing equation and the initial and boundary conditions as was given in the case 1 which we just looked at. So what we are going to say is that in the case 1 we had chosen Ys to be the entire flow domain which was going from 0 to h. So we had chosen a length scale in the y direction to be h. So here right now what we are essentially saying is that the flow or the motion of the wall is confined only till a region of influence. So in this condition we will choose a ys which is given by some delta which right now is unknown. Okay. So I have chosen a scale ys which is given by delta. My Vx scale is the one which is the motion of the wall. So I have that given by u naught. Okay. And the time scale, I am going to choose the time scale associated with the periodic motion. Okay. So that is nothing but 2 pi by omega. Okay. So I am right now very close to the wall. Okay. So there is a small region of influence where the motion of the wall is felt, which is given by delta, and I don't know what this delta is right now. So what we'll be essentially doing is finding out using scaling analysis the value of delta, you know, so we can find out what region will be influenced by that motion of the wall. Okay. So we have the same equation which is given earlier. It was dou v x by dou t. Okay, we have the this was the governing equation that we had initially, the transient term being balanced by the viscous term. So we have right now this was the dimensional equation. We use those scales which were given there to non-dimensionalize this particular equation. So we get rho times u naught here times dou v star. By dou t star. So the time scale was 2 pi by omega. So we have 2 pi by omega here. Okay. This is given equals to u times u naught, which is the scale used for vx, dou square vx star by dou y star square. Okay. And y star is scaled with delta, so we get delta square times y star. So I just have used the corresponding scales and non-dimensionalized my equation. Okay. So if you see, u naught gets cancelled. Okay. So if I rearrange my terms, I would get rho delta squared mu by 2 pi by omega. Is that correct? I think mu comes below into dou v x star by dou t star equals dou square v x star by dou y square. Okay, so I just rearranged my terms. So what I am saying is that right now I am interested in the condition wherein I am looking very close to the wall and the motion of the wall is confined to a region of influence. And when that is happening, when the motion of the wall is confined only to a region of influence, the problem is always going to be a transient problem. So I have to retain the dou v x by dou t in the problem. Okay. So the way you retain is by making this term which is associated with it to be 1. Okay. So you make the term which is associated with dou v x by dou t 2 pi by omega equals to 1. So if only if this is of this term is of order 1. So only if I make this guy 1 will this LHS also become order of 1. So from here I can see that I can get my delta, you know, solved, which is nothing but 2 pi by omega. By is that correct? Root under. Okay. So I have taken it onto the right hand side. Okay. So if I look at this, delta so I could divide delta with h. Okay. To get me delta by h, I just divide delta on the left hand side with h. So I have to again divide h square here because this term is under the root. So I will get delta by h to be 2 pi by omega. Okay, and here I would get h squared and there was a mu here. Okay. So I have delta by h given by this term. So if I look at this guy, I could rewrite it as 2 pi by omega by h square by nu to the power half. okay. So this is nothing but delta by h being given by a time scale which is periodic 2 pi by omega by ts viscous. Okay. So which essentially tells me that the region of influence, which is the fraction of the region of, basically delta by h is how much of it, you know, the fraction of the channel which is influenced. So delta was the region till which the motion of the wall was affecting, and h is the total height of the domain. So delta by h is basically the fraction in which the flow is being affected, is directly given by the time scales ratios, you know, the time scale of the periodic motion by this one, which, so if the time scale associated with the motion of the wall is very low, which means if TSP is less, which means that the plate oscillates very fast, then you will see that the region of influence would be small. Okay, so if TSP is less than TSV, then h would, delta would be small. So which means that if I have a fast moving plate, the region of influence would be very much close to the wall. If it is slowly moving, then I have enough time for the fluid to respond, you know, because viscous time scale is given by the h square by mu. Once I have fixed my h and I have chosen my fluid, h square by mu remains fixed. Okay, and then I could make the entire delta move, or, you know, occupy the entire region or confine it to a small region choosing my omega correctly. So if I choose very small omega, the motion of the wall would be confined to a very small region, and if I choose large omega, then the fluid has enough time to actually, you know, respond throughout the domain. It could be carried out by viscous forces. So for the case 3 problem, which was the region of influence problem, you could use these scales and get the equation directly. So under these scales, you would get that the problem is transient, and you would get the governing equation to be dou Vx by dou t star equals dou square Vx by dou y square. Okay, when you're looking at this problem, you could give the initial condition. Instead of initial condition, you could give a condition, which means the motion of the wall would remain exactly same after, you know, one cycle of oscillation. So you could, instead of using the initial condition, which was the wall being at rest, you could use a periodic condition in time, which means that u, or the velocity in the x direction at t, okay, is the same as velocity after some 2 pi by omega, you know. Okay. So this would essentially, in the non-dimensional frame, because my scale right now I've chosen is 2 pi by omega, would be Vx at t star would be same as Vx at t star plus 1. And then my boundary conditions I already have, which means my wall is not moving, the top wall is not moving at y star equals to 0. Okay. And then I have the other condition, which is Vx star that was at infinity, at h, because the top wall is not moving, y star is infinity basically at that point, because this would come as delta by h. Okay, because I basically have a condition y, this is the condition at y equal to h. So in the non-dimensional frame, it would be y star by y star into, yeah, h by delta. So y was h, so y star into delta is h, so y star would be h by delta. So, and delta is very small right now, so it basically corresponds to a fact that it is infinity. So So I have a velocity which is going to zero as I move away from the wall, and Vx star would be the one which is the periodic motion, which is the given by cos 2 pi t star at y star equals to 0. So you could easily solve this problem and then get the velocity profile for these conditions.